Welcome to this episode of Bone Hunt, Discovering Dinosaurs with AI. I'm Bob Chesebrough. I'm a solution engineer and technical evangelist supporting oneAPI AI here at Intel Corporation. Today's episode of Bone Hunt brings us to the OpenVINO toolkit. I work with my colleagues Raymond Lowe and Zhuo Wu to optimize the code we use for map development using OpenVINO toolkit. The classifier we optimized is great because it works in the real world. Not only that, but as engineers, we want to come up with solutions that work and run well, not just on our own machines, but on other people's machines as well. We wanted to make sure that someone beyond us could utilize this work, and that's what we call a deployment challenge. We wanted to deploy an AI solution for more people to use. When you deploy a solution, you will often encounter problems when deploying at scale. For example, how many people can use it? Or more importantly, related to performance, how can you ensure more people can use it with a good experience? When Raymond and I looked at our solution, we thought it might take about an hour to crunch through a map generation, and the resolution of our initial map was not the best. We imagined a larger, more detailed map would take longer to compute. That's where OpenVINO came in and provided the speedups necessary to do more calculations to generate a higher resolution map. OpenVINO is an optimization tool that Intel created for Intel hardware, particularly x86 architecture at one point, and now it also supports different architectures like GPUs, VPUs, and FPGA. OpenVINO is like a funnel of AI frameworks like Caffe, Onyx, TensorFlow, and PyTorch. With these frameworks, we provide models as input to OpenVINO to optimize across different Intel hardware. When we say optimization, that may be very broad to you, but we explicitly think about how, for example, we can reduce the model size, do quantization, or think about different architectures running coherent work together. We also have some interesting math behind the scenes to trim the graph and make it even more compact so that you're not wasting resources. At this point in our AI lifecycle, I was thinking about this project as an optimization problem. Raymond and I spent about 2 weeks getting our solution out and accelerating it to run on CPU and GPU simultaneously. One of the things that is cool about this is that we leverage the Intel oneDNN library via higher level frameworks without troubling ourselves with lower level details. The way oneDNN works is that when instruction sets like XMX, AMX, and VNNI for Xeon are available, the library automatically takes advantage of that underlying hardware instruction so that we can do computations effectively and efficiently. For example, VNNI is designed so that you can do dot products fairly quickly, which are common operations in AI. Instead of doing three different instructions for the dot product, we have a single instruction, greatly improving performance. Remember, OpenVINO is an open source, easy to use tool to get the best performance from your hardware. It is flexible because it supports CPU, GPU, and VPU. When Raymond and I worked together, we used my laptop to crunch all the numbers for this use case. The CPU was great, but we wanted to go beyond that, and the best hardware I had was the graphics card next to the CPU. With OpenVINO, we could have simply used the CPU, but combining CPU and GPU, we saw significant acceleration. All of this while keeping the power envelope on just a laptop. So I didn't need to buy a server to crunch the numbers. And we easily beat our previous baseline. For the future, what we see in GPUs is exciting with the Intel Arc, Intel Data Center GPU Flex Series, and the Intel Server GPUs now available. OpenVINO has become a very interesting tool that has been built over the last 5 years. It supports multi-hardware platforms as well as software frameworks, and also leverages some of the great work from oneDNN. It is a valuable open source project for everyone in the AI community. That does it for this overview of OpenVINO. Remember that you can find links to resources, tools, and downloads, and where you can learn more about everything in this series in the description. While you're here, like and share this video and subscribe to the Intel Software YouTube channel. Join me in the next episode where we wrap up Bone Hunt, Discovering Dinosaurs Using AI Adventure.
Let the adventure begin.